Take two.
Okay. Sorry about that. Welcome to Hollywood.
Apparently, we can't afford one of those little clapper things in the Air Force. You'd think acquisition reform would be right next to watching wallpaper dry in excitement, but I think the myth's been unveiled. Speed does not sound like it ought to be the thing you focus on most in acquisition. You need to get out and start building as quickly as possible, because that's when you start learning about the new thing you're trying to accomplish, whether it's a satellite or an airplane or a cyber tool. You need to start the process of real-world learning quickly. And the big reform we're trying to do is just get back to our roots as being a rapid builder and fielder of things. We like to talk about flying something before we buy it, but we don't do that very often. We like to commit to buy something, and then we go make it and fly it and hope it works well. Prototyping is the step between. That's a lesson that I think when we have programs come through and field faster, I think historians will look and say that is an old lesson that the Air Force has rediscovered. Software is a new lesson. That software is now something that can change every week, every day. Some companies' hourly software changes are not unheard of. We'd really like to be able to have software go out into the battlefield, get feedback from the users, what was day one of the war like, change it, upgrade it, and be different in day two. And so we have to adopt these commercial development tools that allow us to change software routinely, but change it safely. And this is what we call DevOps. You're developing, but you're developing with the operator. We're in a competition. We're leaving the period of the department's history where we've been focusing solely on violent extremists, and we've now got to compete with adversaries that can bring the same technology know-how, the same military know-how, and build systems commensurate with the ones that we can build. We're going to have to be able to keep building, keep upgrading, keep sustaining faster than any adversary we have. Because if we can't, I don't think we're going to lose dominance today or tomorrow. But because the time constant between our ability to upgrade versus theirs is mismatched, we'll eventually have our superiority erode over time. We can't afford that. But here's the thing that's counterintuitive about speed. When you focus on it as the primary objective, you tend to get smarter acquisitions too. And if you think through it, it makes sense. You can't be fast in an undisciplined way, not for long. Right? If you're a program manager and I tell you to build a hypersonic weapon and go as fast as you can, there might be someone who's not connected to your program that thinks, you're going to chuck your cost estimates out the door, you're not going to do any engineering analysis, risk analysis, because you're trying to save time. But when I tell you to deliver fast, you're going to do absolutely the opposite. Those assessments, those analyses, they become of religious importance to you, because if you don't understand your risk, you're eventually going to trip up and fall. So my experience with telling people to go fast is those things that help you guide your program through the downslopes of risk management, you put at a high priority and you must know them. And those bureaucratic steps that are meant to just keep the paperwork boxes checked that our defense acquisition system so loves, those are the things that you absolutely cut out of your program with extreme prejudice. So my money's on the faster path being smarter and lower risk on the whole. And I'm seeing that creativity across the Air Force, is that when you tell people to go fast, they got to get rigorous on the things that matter, they've got to get pretty severe in cutting out things that don't, and they start thinking outside the box.